this knob will be a holder for the transformer. It fits nicely here. One bolt will be enough for holding the transformer. I used parts which I found lying in my drawer. I found a power cord and a corded switch, and now I have to reconnect it, because I want to be able to turn on the table saw just by pressing on the switch with my foot. I was looking for something for the rectifying in my storage. I have a workshop which is flooded with salvage parts, but I couldn't find proper high current diodes or rectifiers. Then finally I found at least Schottky barrier rectifiers. One package contains two Schottky diodes, so I was able to make a full wave bridge rectifier with three packages. I always check if there isn't any connection between the heatsink and the leads. So the rectifier was done and I mounted it on the frame of the table saw. I made a simple circuit with the bridge and the filtering capacitor, and then I connected it to the motor. I didn't want to spend a lot of time by making some mounting brackets. I ended up just making holders from a piece of a cable insulation. First testing showed me that due to the small saw blade and the small spindle and the friction of the belt, then friction in the bearings and also friction of the material, all this quickly heats up the small spindle. I thought that the heat is maybe too high, so I decided to mount there small fans which will cool down the spindle. For this purpose I add to the table saw a small transformer which will power the two fans. Here was another small problem which I needed to solve. My stub block doesn't get close enough to the blade. There is missing maybe 1.5 mm. I've re-drilled the holes for the alignment pins in slight offset, and this solved the problem. Then I put a hot glue into both holes for the alignment pins, and after that I quickly pressed into the holes a small nail. The advantage of this is that I will be able to realign the pens just by hitting the nail with my soldering gun. The fence will be removable, but also properly mounted to the sled by wing screws. Or it could be if I wouldn't bring from a hardware store about 3mm shorter wing screws. So ordinary bolts will be enough for now. I want this table saw mainly for cutting MDF. I made one test which showed me that the table saw slows down at cutting it. This problem also has the prototype. Fortunately, I know that there is an easy solution. The burnt edge is clear sign that the blade is rubbing against the material. This is a cheap and bad saw blade which does not cut properly MDF. MDF is made from fibers which some of them the blade cuts, but some of them the blade only presses. The pressed fibers tend to go back and push onto the saw blade which causes friction, which also causes the heat and the burn marks on the edge of the MDF material. My solution for this isn't sharpening the blade. I think there can be enough only just bend the teeth onto the saw blade to the sides, and the blade will start cutting wider gap into the material. When the fibers will have the tendency to push, they will have plenty of places and they never get to rub against the blade. I've taken away the blade, which is new, but it is not a hardened steel. Hardened steel has, for example, this hacksaw blade. If this disc would be made similarly and it has the teeth made from hardened steel, it may be cut better, but when I would try to bend the teeth, they would break off because the hardened steel is fragile. I marked the teeth and I start bending them zigzag to the sides. This test shows that my improvement works, because now the blade cuts the MDF without slowing down the motor and without making burn marks on the material. I mounted the switch on a piece of board so I could hold the switch with my left foot and turn on and off the table saw with my right foot. Like this, I can have both hands free. So let's finally put the table saw to some real test. I noticed that my SD cards need a little bit of organization, so I decided to make a small box for them. I start as usual by determining the inner dimensions of the future box. Then I need to know the thickness of the material. Then it's easy to draw a simple plan and calculate the dimensions of all the parts. Usually after this I would have to draw the dimensions also onto the material and then go to cut it with a hacksaw. But thanks to my adjustable fence I can set the dimensions straight to the caliper on the fence and start cutting the parts immediately into the needed length. This is what I wanted to achieve by mounting the caliper onto the table saw, and it seems to work perfectly. I accidentally haven't set the zero properly and I've cut off all my pieces 1mm shorter, but my plan had enough tolerances, so it was no problem. Once I started to cut the MDF, I wanted to play with it the whole day. Sawing creates quite a bit of dust, so I'm thinking about few solutions which may help. Also, I want to mention the motor which I used is relatively quiet. That's one reason why I decided to use this 24-volt motor. Here is a test fit. I am really satisfied with the result because I haven't done anything to the table saw to make it aligned yet. This is my small box. I made a small miscalculation at the plan and I made the box really with my usual method, which comes with the dimensions of the lid. I could just cut off the excess, but like this it also isn't bad. As you can see, the table saw already proved to be a valid piece of the equipment in my hobby workshop. See you at the next project.